encapsulate it anyway for the quality of that and the editing of the video. So it's a very good piece of work.
Okay. So the next presentation is on flight delays for Detroit Airport using Watson Analytics. So this is one of the student projects that big data students had to do for their course. And again, this is one of those where I don't formally teach the students what Watson Analytics is all about, but they kind of pick it up on their own, just like Aaron. Okay. And it was amazing that he managed to find the data on the flight delays from Detroit Airport, which is home to him. And I'm very impressed with the kind of results, the analytics, the insights that he came up with on that. So I'm going to show you the video on his work there. As Richard commented, the video was actually being filmed by the Student Media Services and had help from the school by one of our teachers, Mr. Eric Johnston, who used to work in the broadcasting industry.
It should play.
So what it is that at the end of the school year, the student have to do a presentation, and we actually record them as well and have it uploaded to YouTube. So this is actually a recording, a presentation recording of what he did to the school. And because he cannot attend this conference, so we are showing his video.
Which is not a bad average. Again, it's probably better than this. two adjoining ones are late aircraft delay and carrier delay. So late aircraft delay is basically when an airplane lands late from another airport and the plane is taking off late because of that. I see my dad laughing. He's probably really sad. Number one is carrier delay. So that could be aircraft maintenance, you know, clean waves are moving a little slow, the food is taking a while to make. So we expect to make for carrier delay. We also have weather delay, which is only 4%, which, you know, for Michigan, we get a lot of snow. That's very surprising, it's only 4%, and I'm not really surprised by that. And national airspace system delays is 18%, which basically means there's restricted airspaces in certain areas. So if you've ever been to a football game or a baseball game, the FAA, which is the Federal Aviation, they block off airspace in that area, so sometimes flights have to go around these football and baseball fields. So that's impossibility too. And then security delay represents a very small amount, only about 300 minutes total throughout January to September, and that's again 0%. So this is great and all. It tells us the kinds of delays, so we know kind of how much the total delays are. So let's break it down a little bit. So these are delays per month, and the ball size represents the size of the delay. So I divided it up again into the five different categories by the FAA, the way they divide these categories. And again, the bigger the bubble, the bigger the delay for that month. So it's fairly consistent. You can see most of the delays happen in July and August because it's peak summer travel season. You know, all of us expats are all flying back to China during that late July, early August. And this is people, you know, doing their final summer vacations. I know we would go on, our family would go on vacations in, you know, late August, early September. So we were kind of finding delays sometimes. So most of it's fairly consistent. For the security delays, again, August, it seems so significant. But we have to remember from the last slide, it accounts for 0% of actual delays. So in August, there was a total of about 180 minutes of security delays. So that's no big deal. So I kind of just fire hose a lot of information on you, just about general delays. But in conclusion, flight delays really are just appearing anytime soon. However, since we know how they work through the presentation and the poster, we hope that the airlines will be able to understand what type of delays impact them the most and then help counter them so that we can all get out